Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Keeshia and I love to talk about planners and journals. Today is going to be a long one. I have some really cool things to show you, and just real quick, thank you to all of my new subscribers. If you haven't been here very long, I just had a baby, so quick shout out to anyone who had been praying for us. Thank you so much for all of your prayers. Delivery went well. Baby is happy and healthy and cooing in the background as I film this. So just thank you to all of my friends out there. I really appreciate you. Today we're going to be going through my Erin Condren compact vertical in a harmony neutral, and this is my prayer journal essentially. And so what I have done is I printed out some sticker headers. I saw everyone using these really cute sticker headers in a lot of their kits, and I have way too many stickers. I didn't want to buy any more kits. I'm trying to save money and budgeting and all of that. So I actually have some AC Digitals. The Maggie Holmes collection is all of her collections are my absolute favorite. They were, AC Digitals was having a 20% off the entire site, so I picked up the Marigold collection and the Heritage collection, and those two collections are a really great transitional color palette and design from summer to fall. So I'm really excited to make more stickers using those designs. This one printed out kind of funny. If you don't know, I use a Silhouette, and recently changed up my blade and my Silhouette, and so I'm still trying to like calibrate the settings and things like that, but this sheet turned out all right. So what happened with this guy is when I went to cut all the borders, it cut them all the way through the sticker paper when I just wanted it to like cut like this. So anyway, I measured out all of the headers. This is a monthly header and these are daily headers. Ooh, baby is cooing. Probably need to go pick him up. He can probably hear my voice and wants to hang out. And then this one, I added the month on them just to kind of try it out. So we are gonna play around with these stickers in my prayer calendar journal. It's not exactly a journal, it's a planner, but I'm using it like a prayer journal. And we're gonna see how these fit. So I'm gonna go put baby in a wrap because I think he is awake now and wants to be cuddled while I do this, especially if I'm gonna be talking a long time. So I will go do that real quick and then I will be right back. All right, so baby is nice and secure in my little baby wrap. I use a Moby baby wrap. I absolutely love these things. I got one for my first child too, but when I got it, it was kind of too late. Like it was after she was maybe a couple, I think like 2 months or something, maybe less than that, but they are so great for newborns. So I made sure to get one before Louie was born so that I could use it, and he's just so snug in here. Anyway, let me know if you want to like know more about like mom content. I'm kind of thinking about doing some mom videos, but not really sure if a lot of young moms are watching my channel or not. I think it's mostly just planner related stuff, but if you are interested in that, let me know. I'd be happy to make some videos for you. All right, without further ado, let's get into the planner stuff. So this is the Marigold collection from Maggie Holmes that I printed out using my Silhouette, and I just made some planner headers for the Erin Condren A5 compact vertical. This is actually a notebook cover. I totally bought the notebook just for the cover so that I could put it on my planner. But essentially what we're gonna do today is we're gonna sort of like test my stickers out. So I printed out a few before and noticed that, here, I think like for example, I printed out a monthly one, and I think this one is so big it covers up the days of the week, and I would have had to have my own days of the week there. What I plan to do with that pink one is actually just cut it down. So for this next round, I adjusted the size, and ooh, it like barely fits. So let's just try it out. Might need to cut it just a hair more, but I saw somebody do this trick where they put their planner upside down so that they could line it up real good. And these are sized for the A5 coil. If you wanted to use the A5, it's just a hair too long. If you wanted to use these in the A5 binder, what's it called? A5 agenda, you will have a little bit of white space over here. Darn, that is just so close. So let's see, I'm trying to decide if I'm going to just deal with the size that it is, or if I want to chop off a little bit after I lay it down. I'm just trying to line up my paper real good. Being the perfectionist that I am, I might run this through my paper cutter. Huh. Ooh. I'm just gonna deal with it. I will fix it for next time, but that is good to know. So let's just lay this down for the first time around. And if you are interested, if you have a sticker cutting machine, I have both a Silhouette and a Cricut. If you want to learn how to make these AC digital stickers also, let me know and I'm happy to make a video for you. But I just don't know how many people have Cricuts and Silhouettes. So don't want to go through all the trouble if y'all don't even have a Cricut or a sticker cutter. If you don't have a cutting machine. Oh my gosh. Okay. So I don't think I can handle the words being cut off. This is a struggle. So I'm just going to lay it down like this and then I'm going to take a pair of scissors and chop off the extra up at the top, but cool. That's good for now. And I have spent like 3 years trying to figure out like my sticker maker. I have a full-time job, I've got kids, it's like purely a hobby, so it's been like there's a huge learning curve, but once you get it down, it is a lot of fun and you can have endless possibilities, especially if you're a scrapbooker. I'm basically using scrapbook items for my planners. But anyway, okay, so let's just trim this down. And something I need in the future is like a really accurate ruler. I've been using the Erin Condren ruler to get my measurements on the headers and stuff. And it only goes so far. They only have so many lines on the ruler. I can't get like a super accurate measurement. I just have to kind of do my best here. But, you know, for handmade, this is not so bad. Let's see. This one is just a little tiny bit crooked. And I like to use a removable sticker. a removable sticker paper, as you can see. It is very forgiving if you make a placement on the incorrect spot. You can just lift it right up and have no problem. That's a little bit better. That one like almost makes it, but I guess I did leave a little bit of room on the other one. Ugh, I know, very very perfectionist of me, but let's just try it again. I've been seeing everyone using all of these kits, but something I want to do is save money and I want to make my own. I didn't really see any like patterns in people's shops that I like particularly wanted. And I just know that I love this Maggie Holmes collection. I feel like I keep saying Maggie Holmes all the time, but it's true. And if there is a paper collection that you are really in love with, but they don't make planner stickers, this is an awesome alternative to just like make your own. So much fun. And then it just makes your planner just that much more unique than everybody else's. Okay. Cute. Oh, that's so awesome. I like it. Okay, so I will probably be doing this monthly from here on out. Once I get the measurements right, I think it'll be just perfect. So the way I've been using my monthly is I kind of just do some, write down a, what do you call it? Like a highlight of that day, if it was a particularly interesting day. Like on Friday, I watched a video on mercy. I did a word study today on supplication. I'm watching a series from my church called For Better or Worse. It's about marriage. And then on the 17th, I was just feeling extra grateful, blessed and protected. So I wrote that down. And what I've been doing is I have taken my devotional that is illustrated faith devotional. I punched out coils and I put the book in my planner. I think this is not going to be sustainable, like moving forward. The pages come out pretty easily. There are a few in here that got kind of mangled as I've been flipping pages. So I think what I'm going to, but I do really, really, really love it in my planner. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to archive these pages after the month is over. And what I'm going to do right now in this video also is sort of test out that system. I have some pages that have been, or some weeks that have been completed, and we're going to like file them away in a ring bound system. I know, so complicated going from spiral to ring, but hey, that's the planner life, right? So this is my ring bound system that I want to archive the pages in. I've already done a couple other illustrated faith stuff in here. This is my coach, a half letter notebook. And, but let's go ahead and sort of back plan decorate and put these August stickers in here. So something I'm going to do is like decide what patterns I want to go in a certain order. And I think I'll have the black and white, the blue, the striped, and then the brown. So I will go ahead and fast forward this part, and then we can get into talking about the devotional and how I'm going to archive that. So as you can see, the weekly headers went on a lot smoother than the monthly. And I think if I had to change anything about the weekly headers, maybe I would make a little bit of space up here to see the colored line. But at the same time, I'm really satisfied with the way that this is turning out. So I'm going to now try to archive the weeks that I've already done. And I just realized I haven't really talked about much about how I'm using this, but if you haven't seen my previous video, I just am writing down a prayer every single day. And if I don't do a day, I kind of go back and I decorate the empty days. And then I'm really excited for next month because Illustrated Faith is coming out with their Word Nerd series. And I'm going to be doing the Word Nerd series in this in this journal, and I feel like this is just like just enough space to do like a little quick little word study. So I might switch between word studies and prayers. I kind of already did a little bit of a word study test run here, so I didn't exactly write down like the definition of the word, but in this devotional they talk about let's study Philippians 4, 6 through 8, the word supplication. And so I did a digital word study, actually. Let's see if I can bring that up. And then after doing my digital word study, I, oh, here it is. Oh, interesting. So this is my iPad. The Bible is actually supposed to be, oh, here it is, right here, but it's such a huge file, it's still loading. But this is my digital word study over here, that I did on my iPad. And so, you know, because I had already looked up the word supplication and, read it in my Bible, I went ahead and I wrote down the verse that they're referring to in my Bible, just, I don't know, just because I could have wrote down the definition of the word, but I don't know, I'll probably change it up depending on how I feel. So let's take these pages out. I'm not sure how this is going to go. I probably want to like reinforce this part with washi tape before I punch disc holes in here. So let's do that, and I'll see you in a minute. All right, I just grabbed some washi from my stash that I think might go good with these colors, and we're gonna go ahead and try to reinforce everything before we punch holes. I realize for some of you that may have felt like a ton of extra work, but you know, if this is your hobby, then you'll have fun doing that. But that actually worked out pretty well. So putting the washi tape took about 5 minutes. Punching the holes probably took about another 7 minutes, just because I have to use this as a guide here when I line it up in my happy planner. The happy planner doesn't really have like a great way to measure for half letter. It only does 7 by 9, so you just have to be careful when you're doing that if you're going to be doing the exact same thing as me. But that looks really good. The pages feel really sturdy, even though they've been hole punched for the coil, and they are now hole punched for my little half letter system in here. So I don't know if I'll do the coil again in my planner. I really do like having it in my planner because then I don't have to carry like two things around with me. But it did take quite a bit of time to hole punch the coil, just because of the way the coil punch planner system works. You have to like punch it a whole bunch of different times. If you have what's it called? Is it American Crafts spiral hole punch? You know what I'm talking about. But that went fairly well. I'm just cleaning up my little scraps right here. So super happy with that. So I guess at the end of each week, I will, or at the end of the month, who knows, be putting my devotional in a ring bound plant, my ring bound planner, just to archive it. And so actually what I did earlier when I got this kit was I took the stamp card. Do I have the stamp handy? I don't have the stamp handy that came with the kit, but I took the label, the packaging from that stamp. You can see it says Amen stamp, and I punched it for my ring system here, and then I put a little tab up at the top. So what I actually can do next is make, let's do that right now. Actually, I'm gonna make a little tag at the top here, and we're gonna label it like the unyielding faith, so that when I look back at my little notes here, I can quickly see what this section is all about. That's what I love about these tags here, is like you can switch these out at any point. So I think I'm going to use this. Do I want to use that one? What I'm thinking about is I'm going to need to write the words on here somehow, and I want to make sure that they are going to show up. So I will just washi tape that side. Ooh, can you see? Let's get closer. Whoa. Oh, hi, baby. Baby's moving around in my little pouch. Oh, you got the hiccups now, huh? And we'll washi tape this side. Oops, I didn't go far enough. I'll just fold that over for the sake of time, and then I'm gonna just trim this up. And I have some archival ink, and I have some teeny tiny lettering stamps. I'm gonna see if I can stamp the name of the devotional. And I don't think this is gonna fit. Let's see. Darn. Okay, so I think what I'm gonna do is we're not gonna use the word unyielding. That was after all that. But we are gonna stamp out the word hope. So let me just put all of that back. Sorry for the derail there. But it's just too big. And I will get a permanent marker. All right, sorry folks, had to tend to baby. So the hope didn't stamp out, it was too big. So I'm gonna use this permanent writer, and write unyielding, and then we're gonna stamp hope. Maybe not. We're not gonna stamp hope because it is too tiny. There. Okay. Not gonna think too much about it. I could probably do some like better hand lettering in the future, but that is pretty good for now. Just wanna make this little label up top. Slide that baby in. And now I have a whole little section for my unyielding hope devotional. And that's what the tabs look like. So you can flip to it. I didn't write a whole bunch in the devotional. Did some highlighting and did some underlining, but still like to archive it. I need to buy this section. I actually want to get this printable. They have this in the Print and Pray shop and like make a bunch of these, but we'll see what they come out for Word Nerd next month. I'm sure they'll have a ton of resources in that devotional. So that is the half letter ring bound system. Put this away. And let me just do a quick flip of what it looks like in August in here now. I'll try to clean this up a second. So August looks like this. I have my notes page, the rest of the devotional that I haven't gone through yet that needs to be put into the next couple weeks here in August. This is like my goals page for my prayer journal, and then the journal all decorated. My messy washi tape and supplies on the side. Cleaning up as we go. Just ignore that part. Oops. This sticker came off completely. Let me just gently put that back. But yeah, I love the headers. The headers just, I don't know, add a whole other dimension to this planner. And I'm actually going to get a daily duo and make a whole bunch of headers for the daily duo. And I want to do headers for my A5 agenda. But anyway. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it inspires you to do some sort of daily prayer journal yourself, and let me know what else you'd like to see. Thanks again for stopping by, and all of your support. I will see you in the next video. Bye, friends.